Rob here with Deluxe Gaming, and welcome to the final piece of Tournament 7. Yes, it is the Physics Benders competition. This is the part of the competition where anything goes. It doesn't matter. You can bring anything to the table. There is no restriction. Big, small, in between, spinny, legal, modding. I don't care. It doesn't matter. Bring it to the table. And I guess the theme of this particular competition is... let's see if we can blow up Rob's computer, because we've got so many absolutely monstrously huge ships. There's a whole team of ships that are like over 200, 300, 400, 500,000. I don't know what the biggest is yet here. I haven't taken a close look at it all, but there is a ton of size. Like, there's so many big ships. So this is going to be really exciting. Now, there's a lot of ships here as well. And we'll just, hold on. Let's go to our little... spreadsheet. So there is 39 competitors, but because with the Physics Benders competition, I will allow you to enter in as many ships as you want. There is one person here. Where is he? Nick Longman. He entered in probably, I don't know, there's 20 ships there, at least. So there's a lot of ships. This is gonna take a while. I am gonna have to speed it up at parts. Again, this is not a prize eligible part of the competition. It is totally anything goes, but because of that, I can't offer any prizes. But on that note, like, I mean, it just makes it fun. This is totally fun. And again, this and the Battlecruiser competition are definitely my favorites, just because it's this is just wild. It's just crazy. Anything goes. So, but without further ado, I want to get this going because, this is a work night for me, and it's going to take a very long time to work through all of these ships. I think there's actually more competitors, for this one. Uh-oh. Where? I can't even see the enemy. What's going on? What is going on? Where is the bad? Where are they? I don't even know what's happening. What's happening? Where is the ships? One of them. Okay, so the guy on the right side is spinning. Lapaps now is spinning. And see, this is a downside. This is a problem when you're doing massive ships. Uh-oh. No! No. So, well, there you have it, folks. Oh, no. Well, the goal was apparently to crash my computer, and it looks like the first battle, they've crashed my computer. Well done, guys. Okay, let's not make that the goal again, because that took a long time to put in all those ships. Unbelievable. Oh, no. I think that's it. I think we've completely crashed the game. So I don't know why. We didn't even get to see them fight. That's terrible. So is it something to do with these two ships? I wonder. I don't know. Oh man. Okay. So I'm going to try and reload this again, and I'll be back maybe. I will do my best. Okay. Okay, I'm back. And we're gonna try this again. Please work, please work, please work. So, between the guys in chat, thank you very much for joining me on the stream, by the way, guys. I appreciate it. We've kind of figured out that maybe we had too many ships in the list. Maybe we actually found that limit for Reassembly. There had to be at least 100 ships in the list, and maybe we just had one or two too many, and it caused a crash. So, I think it was Nick Longman. We could only add in, I made kind of a tentative rule for now, only 3 ships maximum per person. Otherwise, it just gets too out of control. So, you still got a few, 3 ships in here. I just picked 3 kind of at random, and this one here with the help of the guys in chat. So, I hope this works. I'm really hoping this works. Please work, please work, please work. Here we go. We are starting again. Physics Benders. Yay. Oh, this looks a little bit more reasonable. And I don't know if anybody's actually tested the limit to see how many ships you can have in a tournament, but I think we just did. I think we found that limit. Oh, that is a pretty ship. It looks like, what kind of drones are those? Red Cyan Lun by Nyx C. Those, it looks like Faction 3, doesn't it? It looks like a Faction 3 ship, but look at those drones. Those are crazy. Oh my lord, look at them. Those look like Faction 3 drones, but I bet you they are some kind of hybrid, modded, crazy... weird thing, but oh, it is a Faction 3 ship. No, it is totally a Faction 3 ship, but the drones actually, it was Faction 3. They dug right through the back of that ship. Oh, that's too bad. That was really awesome. Looks like we have lost our Oh no, it's, I thought we'd lost maybe our sound. Wow, that is Camo 5 in Ubermax. And oh my god, Jesus. Okay, so Ubermax is only like, it's under 8,000p, I believe. It's just tiny. Okay, anyway, so Ubermax's ship, like Camo 5's ship, is super, super, super small, considering, I mean, Decay Spiders by Amazing is, they're using some kind of Gauss weapon that's got some kind of modded thing or whatever. Anyway, it's a total cheat. But that's what this is all about. This is about creating. So I can't, anyway, when I first saw Camo 5's ship and I saw it was so small, I'm like, what are you doing, Camo 5? That's not like you to enter in such a small ship. And here he's got this little tiny ship that just blasts people. Look at this. Okay, so we've got the Shoveler's Missile Spinner. Look at it. It's stopping to take pot shots. Like it's, I like that ship. Look, it's almost like it can spin on demand. It's like, spin now and then stop and take a aimed shot. That is brilliant. Look at that. Lap ups now. You're getting beat up. I'm sorry, dude. But we, oh, and once this is all done, hopefully we'll have time to actually, you know, just throw the spinners all together and see what happens when we pit them against each other. Because I think we did that last time. We do have a lot more ships to go through here, but I can't. I really like the part of the physics spinners where we kind of break things apart and everybody goes, we do little workshops, like a spinner workshop. And this, oh, Gurren Lagann Spiral, is that ever pretty? Now, there was a couple questions as to whether or not we were going to do prizes for this, but I kind of like the purity of the physics benders and not doing prizes. Wow, look at all the drones! That's nuts! That is a huge spinning ship, by the way. I don't know how big it is offhand, but it looks big! And for it to actually spin with the drones, too, as well, that's craziness! Look at that! there was some talk in chat here about whether or not we were going to do prizes for the physics benders for pretty ships. But the problem is, the problem I'm having with that concept is the ships in the physics benders, because anything goes, people just come with such crazy unique designs. Everybody does. So for us to say, you know, one ship is better than another in terms of being pretty, I don't know. Besides that, I kind of like the purity of the physics benders. I like it being kind of anything goes and not have to worry about trying to win, because this isn't about winning. This is just that's a lot of nukes. Null ship, a lot of lag. Somebody just said in chat lag. A lot of lag, because that's a massive ship. Look at all those nukes. I haven't actually started playing any faction 7 yet, or faction 15, whatever you want to call it, the ones with the nukes. Anyway, so each one of those nukes, every single one of those nukes, I think is 2000p or 3000p, like a lot of points to put even one nuke on a ship. And look at how many he's launching at a time. What is that? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and probably 12 on the other side too. Craziness. This might be the ship that's like 823,000. I don't know, it's big. And we're going to do another part of this competition where we just pit the really big ships against each other too, because that'll be fun. Why is it not moving on? Please don't crash. Okay. So much work to actually get all these ships into the tournament. So, oh, and Dark Soul, Frost Flight. And I think this is just one of his regular tournament ships. He wanted me to enter that in. Absolutely no problem. And he is fighting Alien Planet Mover. That, it definitely looks like he's got some kind of multi-faction thing going, but it also looks like a really interesting ship. But I don't know exactly what. He's got to have something big, maybe at close range. Oh, no, maybe it's just a, you know, hey, that would, it almost looks like a, almost looks like it would be something that might be legal, but might have multi-faction. I'm not sure. But anyway, it looks really cool. Looks really cool. I'm just going to speed this one up just a touch. I know that messes with the physics, but like I said, this one's not about winning anyway. And we have a lot of ships to go through here, but thank you. It looks really good. Alien Planet Mover, that looks... You've lost your engines, though. Oh, you had asteroid engines, which are now gone. Frost Flight's Dark Soul is actually... he did very well in the competition, I believe, in the regular tournaments. So this is the same ship. He's actually just entered it into the physics benders just for fun. And it's, if he was facing one of the 800,000p ships, he would probably be struggling right now, but he's not. He's facing Alien Planet Mover, which It's a really cool ship. It looks really, really cool. I'm trying to understand what the plan is. I can't even see what weapons are on the ship. It's hard to see. It's so small. It looks like maybe he's got some plasmas or something on there. I love the colors, that pink and that green. That looks really cool. But Frostflight is literally circling you. Like, he's literally flying circles around you and launching missiles and attacking, or drones or whatever that is, and just kind of beating the crap out of you, dude. Sorry. But anyway, thank you for entering in your ship. Doomster, please enter in another ship. I think this was your first entry. Thank you very much. Appreciate it. Love having new entries in. And now we've got Iblob Touch versus in his Mind Spinner ship. I was just saying to the guys in the chat, wow, did you see that? Null, it looks like a multi-faction spinner with death rays. Like, whoa, look at all those engines. I love the way they're placed. It almost looked very organic. That is a cool looking ship. I was gonna say about Iblob Touches, it's just interesting that you can make spinny ships that don't kind of have those corners or those edges like you normally see on spinny ships. Oh, look at those drones. I wonder if those drones are modified at all, because look at them just, they're look how fast they're going first off, and they're just tearing into, it's not a swastika by, I'm not sure who that is. I'm sorry. And Shaky Box, this is Shaky Box in Romance. Shaky Box, I think, is watching right now. He is also, if you remember, Shaky Box in the regular tournaments, he did enter in the, he's actually watching right now. He entered in the Number J, which surprised us all, which was a troll ship. But look at those drones. I wonder if those are modified. I don't know, but it looks like they're just tearing him apart. But they actually have not killed him. So I'm wondering if maybe he's using some kind of crazy command module in there, or maybe those... Maybe modded the blocks or something on that ship so that they can't die. Because he looks like he's taken a lot of damage. Well done, Shaky Box. Good first entry. Does he have nukes too as well? I'm just trying to see Shaky Box. No, I don't think he... If you look at Shaky Box's ship up in the top left, it looks like he's trying to build a laser cannon in the back of his ship, but he can't build it. It looks really bizarre. Looks like he's trying to build some kind of defensive gun. Like, I'm trying to understand how, maybe there's some kind of overlappy thing that's preventing that gun from actually appearing. Really bizarre. But anyway, good job, Shaky Box. You've created a runner in the, for the physics benders. That's fantastic. We're just going to speed that up, let you pelt him with your little, but I gotta tell you, it's not a swastika, and it still spins. That is the key. So you don't only have, you have options when you're building your spinny ships. They do not have to have that crossy kind of look. They can kind of have that funky kind of look, but we've already seen a couple of those in this competition that you see a lot of them that are kind of shaped like spheres, and there's all sorts of different designs you can make or do to make spinny ships. But what's interesting is that I don't know what kind of weapons that is using, but it looks like he's got, is that mines or something? Oh, no, or maybe it's missiles, I don't know, but whatever it is, you'd think once he starts spinning that they would actually propel themselves enough to hit Shaky Box, but it's not happening. Shaky Box is just dodging like a pro. Look at him. I wonder if he's using some kind of crazy engine, modified engine or something. Anyway, really well done. Super fun to watch. Look at those drones, eh? Very cool. Well done, Shaky Box. awesome. Ultron. Oh my god. A faction four. And this is, I think that guy, he's big. Look at, he's already done 41,000. Look at all those missiles. Oh my god. Codename Swarm Liberation. Look at them all. Look at that. Is he actually going to start taking through? Oh no, here comes the nukes. Come on, dude. Oh, look at the missiles, chew them apart. If it wasn't for the nukes. Yeah, the nukes are, the nukes will win battles. Oh, there's that big. That's one of the biggest Faction 4 guns we've ever seen. I can't wait to break up these fights into smaller little fights. You know, we're going to do the really big ships against each other. That'll be super fun. We're going to do the spinny ships against each other. Look at this quadrillion. I was making a comment before that it kind of... And it looks like it's a spinny ship as well, versus Cursor. Oh my god. Cursor. Oh, Jesus. Yeah, I was making fun of, or playing, mentioning, who was it? Whose ship was that? Quadrillion. The ship, it kind of looked like Tron got squished by a big tractor or something. Looks kind of... And here we've got Starstrike in a spinny laser ship! Somebody built me a spinny laser ship! Thank you! That's awesome! Oh, that's too bad! It looks like there's lasers on buzz weapons, or a number one Reaven ship too as well. Oh, I love the idea of a... Yeah, just cut through! Oh, it doesn't look like they're doing enough damage. Maybe if you modded the lasers or something, like, I want to see extreme damage from those lasers. I wonder if there's a laser that just does enormous amounts of damage, and if you could just put tons of... Oh, look at that! Oh, it just doesn't look like they're doing enough damage. I love the concept. Oh, man. I'd love to see a laser ship that just cuts through the enemy and just rips them apart. That'd be awesome. Anyway, thank you for building that ship. I think last time, the last physics benders we had, I requested that ship. And here we go. Energy Absorber 2. And it looks like he's got a big nuke on him. And I'm not sure what else, but he looks like he's multi-faction, but he's got a factory too as well. Looks like he's got some fuzzy stuff on the side. But I'm sorry, amazing ship. He's using this some kind of... Same with Camo 5. They're using some kind of crazy Gauss weapon that... really is absolutely terrifying, plus all those drones. Oh my god. Don't worry, everybody's gonna have a second chance in the competition here. Well, it's not really a competition. Everybody's gonna have a second chance to fight sort of it a little bit more in their own category. I don't think there's much of a chance. Oh my god, look at all the drones. Modular Gauss. Shaky Box is saying it's a modular Gauss cannon. I don't know what that means. Yeah. Wow. Computer hasn't frozen yet, but I bet you the frame rate just went to like, well, obviously the frame rate is like nothing. So, I'm probably gonna have to adjust the video so that, look at all the schmutz coming off the side of the ship. Look at that, look at all the stuff. I'd love to see the insides of that ship. You know, I do have that power. I could actually load it up. But okay, come on, let's go to the next one. When there's this much stuff in the air, it just gets crazy slow and there's nothing I can do to speed it up. Well, I suppose I could fast forward it. And if it does take too long, I will fast forward it, but you won't even know and you won't hear what I'm saying because this will all be fast forward. okay, come on, anytime now. Uh-oh. But hey, look, you only did 6,544 damage. Actually didn't do very much. Okay, so here we go again. Oh no, the Gauss, no! It doesn't have super long range, but... Oh, wow. Oh, geez. It looks like it actually thwarted it, like it threw him away. Like the Gauss hit him and he actually went, he went flying away, like they pushed him away. That is crazy. So it looks like the drones are going to finish him off. I'm just going to speed this up as much as possible. Trust me, it's not going to matter. It'll only go as fast as the game will allow it. So see, we're still at 1 minute 22. 1 minute 20. There we go. And I think... Even right now, the ship is still launching stuff, so every time he launches something, it slows down the game a little bit. I really can't wait to see these big ships fight against each other, and we have a lot of really big ships. I am super stoked about that. Hopefully I have enough time to record it all today, because this is taking a long time. Come on! Amazing, your ship is too big. Okay, here we go. Shoveler's Missile Spinner versus Explorer. It's built in a funny way. Explorer, Spinny, it looks like he's launching antimatter guns. I think it's antimatters. And he is actually doing a ton of damage, enough to maybe start to take down those shields. It is possible, because those projectiles are hitting him pretty fast. Actually, look at those. Those are antimatters. I think those are antimatter, the big antimatters. Faction 2 antimatters, I think. And if you have enough of those will do a ton of damage. And look, he's hitting with every single shot and still spinning at enormous rates. So, Shoveler's Missile Spinner, it looks like he can sort of spin on demand, and then when he takes a shot, he actually stops. But... The shields are coming back way too fast. There's no way. He's not going to get through. There's no way. But could he actually apply enough damage to win the fight? He may actually pull it off. Look at this. We don't see this a lot in the physics benders, where it actually runs out the time and you win by just points. Usually there is a death. It's really terrifying. You wouldn't normally want to bring a ship to the spinners, or sorry, to the physics benders competition, thinking that you might want to salvage it later, because usually they just get wasted in the end. But yeah, it looks like Shoveler's actually going to win the fight by just applying more damage. That never happens. That is crazy. That is crazy. Shoveler, well done. You've got a ship that actually kind of dodges the enemy too as well. Like, that's nuts, man. That's nuts. Like, you're dodging, you are applying a lot of damage with those animators. That is craziness. And look at him. Watch him. So watch really closely at Shoveler's ship. You can see him actually moving out of the way of the missiles and the drones. He is getting hit, but not very much. He is dodging them. And he still has time to stop and fire his main gun. Otherwise, and then he's hitting him as well with whatever he's using, like, I don't know what kind of weapons are shooting as well. There's some kind of autocannon or something there. But that's awesome. And look at all those drones. The drones are like, they don't know how to deal with it. And he just flies right through and he's barely getting hit at all. That's nuts. Well done, Shoveler. That is an awesome ship. I really like it. dude, and you're going to win by points. That's crazy. Absolutely craziness. I think, Audie Cook Me, I think you need some bigger weapons on there or something. Or, I don't know. You need to be able to... These spinners, man, they are effective. Really effective, actually. Frightening, sometimes. Okay, here we go. We are on to... I allowed Shaky Box to enter in the number J. And this big, big, big drone spinner, right? We've seen this. It's huge. It's absolutely massive. Now... If we were talking before the episode began, I was just chatting with the guys in chat in Steam as we stream, and I was saying if the number J won, I would think there's some kind of voodoo attached to this ship because it did so well during the main competition. But it looks like Troll Ship and the Physics Benders, yeah, not so much. I think, look at it, it's getting eaten. It looks like a lot of bugs, like when you're watching ants eat something and they do it really fast, like they do the speed up photography. I forget what that's called. He's just getting eaten. Anyway, thanks Shaky Box for entering in that ship. Oh, here we go. The first two big ships to fight. Look at that. Faction 4 gun not aimed very well. If you're going to fire a gun like that, aim it. Oh no, here it comes. Oh, look at that. The shields are going down. But look at the nukes. The nukes are going to start coming in. Oh no. And there's only two nukes. Oh my god. Look at that. Cutting through. I think the ship on the left that has no name and the ship on the right that has no name. I think the ship on the left is, I think it's a 423,000 ship. It might be more than that. And the ship on the right, they're both the hundreds of thousands. Oh my god. Okay, but here comes the nukes. The nukes are coming in. I wonder if he's got enough. He might have enough point defense to actually defend against all of those nukes. I don't know. There's a lot of them. What? What just happened? What just happened? I don't understand. I'm going to speed this up. Holy crap. I don't even know. What? He's a spinner? What is going on? He's turned into a spinner. that's why they call this the physics spinners, because all of a sudden you can turn your 1 million P ship into a spinner. What? I don't know. I don't think it's a 1 million P. I don't know. There is a ship in this competition that's 800 and some thousand. I'm not sure which one it is, but I don't think it's these two. I could be totally wrong. Look at all the stuff in the air. I was about to swear there, but I didn't. There is a lot of stuff in the air. I'm going to keep this at as fast as possible. I don't know if that's going to do us any good. I might have to fast forward this part just so that we can get through these battles, because this is at 16 times. Look at this. Milliseconds are actually running slower than seconds. And I do work tomorrow, so I can't have this go on all night, but whatever. I'll just let it go. Okay, I'm going to fast forward this part for you guys.
Okay.
We're almost done. It looks like unnamed opponent on the right, Null on the right, is winning this one. let's slow it down here. Because we don't want the next battle to start at super, super speed. Oh, you can kind of see what's on the inside. Oh, man. Pressing space will end the fight? Oh, I didn't know that. Somebody was just saying, I don't want to test it right now because I don't want to ruin everything just in case, it skips us back to the beginning. Oh, man. It's too bad. If he just stopped turning, it would have been really cool. That would have been really cool to watch him just cut right through the very, very center. Yeah, somebody was just saying in chat, if you hit spacebar, it'll skip to the next battle. Maybe we could try that next time. I worry, though, that that's going to mess things up, and we really don't want to mess things up because we could screw up the whole tournament. I don't want to do that. We've come so far. Look at those nukes. The nukes actually got through. Oh, my God. Oh, wow. Look at that. Oh, wow. Wow. Actually, that is really bad for him. Oh, boy. If more of those nukes can get through, he's in big trouble. He's never going to be able to repair all of that. There's no way, especially with the drones coming in too as well. That is actually really, really crazy. Just so everybody knows, we are operating in 2x speed. If it starts to slow down too much, I will speed it up a little bit more. But look at he's actually going down. The nuke's actually, oh no, he did the thing where he spun away again. Oh no, okay, time to speed it up. Yikes. Here we go again. Oh, okay, well. I think the unnamed Null on the left is going to win this one just because those nukes actually, they contacted. That is crazy. Okay, so I'm going to speed this up. I'm going to fast forward it for you guys at home so that you don't have to sit here and endure. But keep in mind, the last battle took probably 5 or 6 minutes. This one probably will too. So that's why we're fast forwarding this piece. So I will talk to you in a second. Okay, I made an executive decision to hit the spacebar just to test it. I said I wasn't going to, but that honestly, that was taking forever. We've been sitting there I've been sitting here for at least 5 or 6 minutes, and we have a lot of ships to go through. And besides that, Null on the left side was winning, and we were pretty sure he was going to win it. This is the last battle between these two. I was kind of hoping to see that gun, that big modular gun shoot right through the center. Oh, and if it doesn't win it right away, we're just going to spacebar through. So that spacebar does actually work. So that is really good to know for the future, especially for physics benders, that we can use spacebar to skip a battle, or it will, whoever's winning at the time in terms of points, we hit spacebar and that will be the winner for the battle. So that is actually brilliant. And thank you. I forget who mentioned that in the chat. That is absolutely spectacular. Thank you so much. Well, look at those nukes. I just don't think there's enough firepower right at the beginning here to actually take him out. Oh my God, that's a lot of damage though. Did you see how many nukes went off there? It's crazy. It gets so slow though. Like, we're at 16 times right now, and it gets slower than this. It's so slow. And so if he starts to spin away again, then we will... Oh, look at that! Oh, the main shields are down! Could this be the end of right side Null? Wow, look at it! There's nothing... Oh my God! Look at that! Wow, look at that. That is crazy. That is a legitimate win. Oh my God. That is crazy. Is there a command module left? Like, wow. The damage is insane. He's using some kind of modded command module. That is awesome. Wow, look at that. Oh my God. Oh, that's just crazy. That's craziness. I remember there is some kind of command module that you can have that's literally unlimited amounts of points, of hit points, and it just pretty much can't die. So I'm wondering if that's what's happening here. I'm not sure, because you can see it actually in the top center of the screen. There is a command module there, and it keeps getting hit with the nukes, one after another. It's smoking. and it's some guy sitting in there going, hee-hee, can't get me now! it's the final insult to injury. But look at the amount of points. Okay, so now this is a race to see. Doritos is saying it's an indestructible part. I think that's pretty much indestructible. So, but it's interesting to see how many points that null number on the left side can do. So he's up to 191. Let's see here. I don't think we can speed this up any further. Well, yeah, it's a little bit. I just want to see how many points he can do. So he's up to 195,000. And yeah, it's totally indestructible. There's no way it can take that many hit points damage and survive. There's no way. So I think we'll just skip on to the next one. But yeah, he did what? Almost 200,000 points damage? That is crazy. Awesome. Well done. Okay, we are going on to the next one. And thank you so much for who mentioned the spacebar thing, because that's incredible. For the physics benders, that's absolutely necessary here. Okay, so here we go. We are back to, Exciter. Exciter is in the competition, and he's in Excitecheat. It is a faction 4 cheating sniper ship. Ha ha ha. Versus Daddy Planet Surprise. Interesting face-off. I wonder who's going to win this. So Plant Planet Surprise. I wonder what the surprise is. Do you see it? I see what the surprise is. The surprise is he has plants on him. How did he do that? That's crazy. Are they growing? How did he do that? That's nuts. I had no idea that you could put the... So if you remember in the main campaign, there's these plants that grow everywhere and they shoot the little yellow bits at you, and it can cause all sorts of slowdown, and they're just a huge pain in the butt. But Daddy, Plant Planet Surprise, well, oh my God, there's a surprise. Surprise! Wow. Amazing. So he must have built that with a sandbox or something. How did you do that? That's incredible. That's incredible. I had no idea you could use the plants. How did you use the plants? You know what? As soon as I need to figure out how to use a sandbox and then do a tutorial on sandbox. Yeah, I'm talking about teaching something I've never touched before. Well done, Exciter. Wow. Wow. That was a brilliant shot, my friend. Holy crow. Oh, so close. Brilliant. Oh my God. That is... Look at... He did more damage than that big ship in the last battle. 205,000 damage. That is incredible. Well done, Exciter. That is so cool. So this is like a major faction, but how did he get the plants on the ship? That is incredible. I'm going to speed this up just because... Yeah, we need to speed it up. I do need to work tomorrow, and I've already gone way too long. I think we're in over an hour already. So I'm definitely going to have to fast forward some parts. But it looks like Exciter is, look at him, he's up to 253,000 points. Planet Daddy, or Planet Surprise, has a lot of hit points. I think that's part of it. Crazy, crazy cool. I want to know how you put the plants on the ship. I'm sure it's all done with the sandbox. Very, very cool. Very impressive. All right, so now we've got Null. This is one of the spinny ships that launches nukes. Look at them all! Look at all the nukes! Oh, Jesus! But Enigma just dug right in with proton swords? Really? And nukes. Proton swords and nukes. Look at it! Look at the damage! Look at the damage! That's crazy! Wow. That is insane. That's insane. The nukes, they sure do know how to change a fight with the nukes. I'm a little nervous about doing just a battle with just the big ships because it takes a long time. It takes a really long time. We'll see how we're doing for time at the end of this. I'm just going to speed this one up. Shaky is just going to run and pelt and pick on somebody until they die. Well done, Shaky. Well done. Well done. Yeah, look at him. 11. He's taking 11 points damage. He doesn't need to do a lot of damage. All he's going to do is just dodge. Look at him dodge. Zoom, zoom, zoom. Go left, right, left. Hurricane beat him. What? Something hit him. Oh no, Shaky, you gotta dodge, dude! You gotta dodge! Use the force, man!
Use the force, Shaky.
Dodge! Shake. No, no, you lost! No, 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 no!
Oh, that's it.
Well done, Hurricane. I think that was Ethan123. Well done. Green Star versus Angry Thoroplast. I love the name. What? Oh, he's using a teleporter. Ah, teleporters. The question is, how are you going to do damage from way over there, Chloroplast? Didn't think that went through very well. It looks like he's dividing. Look at him. Looks like he's like dividing into something else. That's crazy. Like he's leaving a copy of himself when he teleports. That is nuts. Look at him go. You're so far away. Nobody's ever going to win the fight. Actually, what's funny is whoever has the most hit points is going to win. And it's probably Green Star. Looks like he's maybe a little bit heavier. Look at him. He's all over the place. He's just teleporting pointlessly. Yeah, there's... Oh, no, oh, no! I wonder, is there any... You have no control over where you land, I think, with the teleporter. It's just all over the place. Look at that. That's crazy. Ah! Ooh! Seems counterproductive, but okay. All right, well, we'll just put that at four times because it looks like all he's going to do is bounce around. And Green Star is doing his best. He's trying to catch him, but... Oh, unless... Chloroplast crazy. So he chloroplast had more points or he actually did some damage. I don't know. Super funny. Cursor. Oh. Well. Thanks for coming out. It was wow. Cursor. No. Dodge. Go left. No. Damn it. good fights. All right. Buzz Weapon, number one Reaver versus the Windy Hills by Purple Electric Tiger. He's been doing some crazy stuff with his engines lately, so... It looks like it's a spinner! Oh, boy. No, dodge! Oh, how are you taking direct hits like that? Purple Electric Tiger, were you cheating? That's okay. Very cool. Buzz Weapon, it looks like Buzz Weapon could... What kind of weapon is that? Yeah, I think he's using a Goss Weapon, too, as well. Kind of like Camel 5 and Amazing... It's a really fast... Oh, maybe it's not. Maybe it's not. I don't know what it is. But it's firing really fast. Purple Electric actually is doing okay. He needs to apply a little bit more damage and not get smushed like that. Okay, I think Buzz Weapon, you can probably just go over there and crush him. Crush him! Finish him! Finish him! Get over here! Oh. Are you kidding? All that's left of these little guys. It looks like Buzz Weapon didn't lose anything. Like, what kind of armor has he got on there? I wonder if he's modified the armor. It's very cool. It's very, very cool. Ah, there we go. Done. Perfect. Okay, so now we are on to the... Oh, we're still on... We're working on the final lane. Okay, Uber Max using his crazy Goss Weapon. Teleporter! Okay, faster... I don't know... alright, so yeah, 8 times? Uh-oh, this is gonna be a problem. And it started to slow down. Oh, no. Yeah, no, that's unacceptable. But it looks like he launched a whole bunch of drones and stuff before he teleported away. The question is... Okay, we're going at 16 times. Ugh. So, was it amazing that teleported? It must have been amazing. I think Amazing teleported away. Maybe it was Camo 5. It's always interesting to watch Camo 5 versus Amazing because they're two of the old schools. They're the guardians, right? The guardians of the alpha of Reassembly. Like they know the ins and outs of this game. It's definitely amazing that it's teleporting. He just teleported again, I think. I'm pretty sure. I don't know. I really want to know who wins this fight. I want to fast forward it, but. Or just hit spacebar and go to the next fight, but I really want to know who wins this fight. I think it's going to be Amazing. I think because Amazing is hitting, like he's, but can he actually apply enough damage? I guess that is the question. Where is Amazing? Like he vanished, he's gone. Oh, I thought maybe he went to his alternate dimension. It looks like Camo 5 is getting pelted. But it doesn't look like he's taking any damage. It's pretty funny. I wonder if he's modded the shields or something crazy. Maybe he's taking damage? But if you look at the top right, it doesn't... Yeah, somebody's saying, is a teleporter really necessary? I don't know. I don't know if I'd want to... Well, maybe in a one-on-one fight, I don't think that Camel 5's ship would do so well here. I think facing head-to-head with Amazing. I think Amazing... It maybe wasn't necessary to do the teleporter, but, you know. I think we're just gonna skip it. There we go. It's just, it takes way too long. Way too long to do it. So, I hit the spacebar there, just so you know. So, Camo 5, you didn't officially lose. I just skipped ahead. I think what we'll do is, I can't put out a 2-hour video. So I think what we're going to do is we're going to work through all of these. And then if maybe we'll do another, I'll do another little one this week of just the spinners or something, or just the big guys or something, because this is just taking way too long. Oh, look at this. Even this, way too long. Wow. Once you get a ship so big, I think a teleporter is absolutely pointless. I mean, there is no way Amazing is losing a fight. Okay, we're still waiting. So the battle's over. We're still just waiting for the battle to be over. Oh, good God. So if Amazing doesn't kill him right away, or Camo 5 doesn't actually get a good shot in and kill Amazing, I think we just skip ahead because these fights just take way too long to execute. And I am still a little bit concerned that the computer's going to crash. The teleporters kind of ruin it because I'd like to see just the two ships just fight, right? So, I don't know. You're welcome to put teleporters on your ships for the physics benders. Don't get me wrong. I want you to put teleporters on your ships if you want to put a teleporter on your ship. However, I think it makes for a better fight. Yeah, okay. I'm just going to skip ahead. Skipping ahead. Yeah, Amazing. I'm sorry. It's just we can't just sit here and wait. It just takes way too long. Take the teleporter off your ship. It would have been a really cool fight just to watch you two duke it out. That would have been really cool. And if it makes it feel any better, I think you have the winning ship between the two, just because I think your ship is like, I don't know, is it like 800,000? I don't know. It's big. It's really, really big. dude. I like the name too. It's too bad we can't see that it's actually a spider. There's so many shields. How long does it take to make a ship that big, I wonder? I don't know. Crazy. Crazy, crazy big. All right, so now we have Shubler's Missile Spinner, which is doing really well at dodging. In terms of spinning ships, it is a dodging master, and it's always hitting with the... Uh-oh. The problem is when you have that many B-drones... No! There it goes! Oh, he got chewed up by the gauntlet there. Oh, man, that was brutal! Drone spinner, wow. Nice ship. I really like that. That is very, very cool. Look at them. Here they come. Zap, 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 zap. And it looked like Shubler actually got bashed around a little bit by the, you know, just kinetically crushed. Look at him. Just chewed him up. Done. Done deal. Looks like we're getting slowed down in the game overall. Like we're getting a little bit of lag here. We are trying to... Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, no. Just as long as I don't teleport away. Well, yeah, the problem is when they bounce, that is a problem. Look at all those nukes. Oh my God, I don't think we've seen this ship yet. Look at all those nukes. Look at them all. Oh my God. You can't dodge them all. Look at them all. That's nuts. Oh my God, here they come. Oh my God, no! Can you imagine? Captain, there's something on the... Oh my God, look at that. Wow, look at that. Whoa, beautiful shot. Well done. It's solid nukes from one end to the other. That is incredible. Oh, except I think those are animators or something. I don't know, they're probably something big. And they problem is you can't get close enough. Is that a troll ship? I don't know if it has engines. We can't tell. We know the other ship has engines. The nuke ship has engines, but the animators are just taking out a small portion of those nukes. What? What? Look at the blasts of the nukes are actually forcing the nukes to get blasted back. Is that ever cool? Is he actually moving closer? I don't know. If he moves close enough, those big animators might actually do some damage, but now there's twice as many nukes in the air.
Oh, man. There's no defense for that, except for maybe teleporting. Teleporting is the only thing I can think of that might help.
Whoa, look at that. So I guess your own nukes must damage your own nukes if they're within a certain range, and they probably only take a small amount of damage. Oh, he's in range of those animators or whatever they are. Look at that.
Oh, but those nukes. Oh, here. Yeah, the nukes are coming in. Yeah, it's all over, I think.
Oh, they're coming in from the side. Oh, look at him. Oh, my God. That's so crazy. That is so crazy. Oh, look, he's got some kind of animator or something in there. Oh, my God. Wow, look at that. Look at the colors. Oh, he is actually taking damage from the blue animators, too, as well. Oh, my God.
Oh, that is some intense damage. 355,000 points of damage. Definitely a new record. I don't think we've seen that much damage. That is craziness.
All right, Dark Soul in Frostflight. Or sorry, Frostflight and Dark Soul. Exciter just ate you for lunch. Nah, Exciter's gonna chew you up, spit you out, I think. I don't think there's much of a chance.
Exciter, not only does he make really good Faction 4 ships, he makes highly accurate Faction 4 ships that are really good at sniping and keeping at range, but then you say to Exciter, build me a ship using any rules you want. Don't follow any. I don't care. And what is he going to build? A Faction 4 ship that can do twice as much damage at twice the range and barely even break a sweat. So, but don't feel bad, Frostflight, because you are, I think his ship, Dark Soul, is, I think it's an 8,000p. And I think Exciter's is pretty darn big. I really like the look of Dark Souls. You know, at the beginning, I didn't understand it. Now it's starting to look like a circuit to me. It looks a little bit like a circuit, like a black circuit. I don't know. Maybe not. Yeah, it looks like a motherboard. Looks like a circuit board, doesn't it? I don't know. I think it does. Okay, I'm going to speed this one up. Exciter, you just can't get the kill, man. Come on, take the shot. Get the kill. you're playing with him. You're toying with him like a little pet. Like a gerbil, like a cat and mouse. A game of cat and mouse. You're just toying with him. Look at that. Look at that shot. It actually slowed down the game. Crazy. Okay, well done, Exciter. You are on to the next round. Hurricane versus Enigma. Gotta admit that Dark Soul, you know, you still want to fight. You beat Daddy in the plant ship. That's awesome. I want to see the plant ship again. I really want to see... Wow. Ethan, you just got crushed by nukes, man. There is a lot of nukes on that ship. Oh, see those drones? Those are the Borg drones. Borg drones are different from the bees. It's a different type. So there's three types of laser drones. There's the B drones, there's the Faction 3 drones, and then there's the Borg drones. And the Borg drones, we don't get to see them very much because I said that we can't use them in the regular tournament, but they're very cool. Ah, right, Chiroplast, he just bounces around and yeah. Oh, crazy. Look at him. He gets in close and then he zaps away. Oh, he is. Did he actually do any damage? I don't think he did. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Ah! I don't believe it. Frostflight actually won that fight. Chiroplast, all that fancy maneuvering didn't do you any good. Look at this. Bounce, bounce, bounce all over the place. It's like a ping pong ball. Boink, 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 boink. Look at him. But nobody's actually done any damage. Somebody do some damage. Come on. This is a fight. Come on, hit him! Unbelievable. Frostflight wins it. Frostflight! I don't believe it. You are actually going into the final four with an 8,000p ship. Amazing. Ultron MK3. This looks terrifying. Buzz weapon, you've lost your buzz. Did you notice he kind of exploded there? He just kind of shattered into pieces. That is one badass gun. Exciter, I don't know how you're gonna deal with that. That is one badass gun, man. I don't know. Ultron's pretty scary. I think Ultron's Ethan's too as well. I think so. I think that's Ethan 123's. I'm pretty sure. Alright, so now we've got... Oh, Drone Spinner. Drone Spinner's pretty damn good. But I don't know, against Amazing's teleporting craziness. I don't know, I think the teleporters, especially on the big ships, I don't have the patience to run through the whole battle. I don't have the time to run through the whole battle. So I worry once these drones get close enough that Amazing ship is actually going to zap away, but maybe not. This is, okay, I'm going to, slow it down, speed it up. Here we go. Maybe that'll help. I don't know if drone spinners, his drones are there, but it looks like Amazing has lots of point defense. Of course Amazing has a lot of point defense. So even though you're launching a lot of drones, but if those nukes get in close, which might just happen, those are all nukes. That little cluster that's moving in on the drone spinner, I'm pretty sure those are all nukes. So if they get close enough, that's it for drone spinner. Of course, then the rest of the drones, the B drones that I think Amazing has, they will finish drone spinner off if those nukes go. Oh, looks like they're slowing down. Maybe not. I'm pretty sure those are nukes. I can't tell because everything's so small. I have pretty good eyes, but not quite that good. Are those nukes? Those have got to be nukes. They're too big to be just regular drones, but they're just almost there. Almost there. Looks like... Oh, man. Maybe they're not. Maybe they're something else. They look like... Oh, and they're gone. Oh, crazy. Okay. So what are they then? I thought they were nukes, but maybe they just didn't get close enough to detonate or something? I don't know. There is a lot of drones on Drone Spinner, but I don't know if that Amazing can actually do enough damage to those... Oh, look at him launch all those drones. That's crazy. It is slowing right down again. Oh. There we go. Oh, whoa. Didn't mean to do that. There we go. Oh, we almost nicked him. Oh, almost so close, but... You know, I think Drone Spinner actually, you know, stands a chance of doing okay in a fight. If he can actually get away from all of the drones coming at him. But I don't think he's fast enough to do that. I think in the end, Amazing will win the fight. We're just gonna skip it just because, again, it's just a time issue. It's just too much. Look at when he fires all those lasers and stuff. That is nuts. That's nuts. Like, you don't wanna get close to that ship either. It's just, it is trouble all the way. About that, guys, I just had to step out for a second, and because I can't stop the stream and I can't stop the game from playing, so I hope you enjoyed a little bit of music while this looks like Exciter is fighting the big guy here. Looks like Exciter's done 42,000 points damage. He's just sniping him. That's crazy. It's craziness, I tell you. So that's nuts. So Exciter's, I mean, I don't remember how big his ship is, but it's certainly not as big as the Null on the right, I think he's just solid nukes, if I remember correctly. I don't know that he could actually, I don't know if Exciter could actually do enough damage to kill the other guy, but he'd have to be close enough to actually apply damage, first of all, he would have to be close enough to apply damage, but he's definitely not close enough, I don't think, anyway, and I don't know if I'd want to get close to that many nukes anyway. I think we'll just skip ahead and we'll say that Exciter won it. Perfect. Done. I'm loving the spacebar thing. The spacebar thing is amazing. The problem is it's too easy to hit spacebar. Okay, here we go again. Now, Exciter already did 20-some thousand points. Crazy. Look, he actually did take out part of the shield. The problem is he just can't get... He's not close enough now. He's too far away. He'd really have to get close to apply some serious damage. And with all those nukes in the air, do you really want to do that? I don't know. Exciter, it's an amazing ship, man. It's really good. It's really good. I actually didn't think a regular sniper ship would do so well here. But yeah. Okay, I think we'll just say that you got that because you're not gonna get any closer. We're just gonna say that Exciter won it. Well done. Really awesome. Really, really awesome. I wish I knew who built these null ships. I mean, I can look it up in the end, but the null ships are really amazing. They're so big and they slow down the machine so much. Whoa, Enigma! He's actually done very well, too. He's small, he's light and fast by comparison to some of these other ones. Interflame, oh, Frost Flight. Right, that was an 8,000 piece ship, by the way. Against all those nukes, that's crazy. That's nuts. Enigma is pretty awesome. All right, so we got Ultron versus Decay Spider. This is gonna be scary. Oh, and he teleported away. Oh no, looks like all those Goss guns did some damage, but, and maybe those drones will come in and do some damage too. I guess we'll just wait and see for a second. I'm not gonna wait very long. See, you can see the drones attacking now. I just want to see if they will actually get into the soft underbelly. I don't think so, because it looks like Ultron has quite a bit of point defense there too as well. He's actually taking out the drones. So that's good. Yeah, it's a well-built ship. We're not going to sit here and wait for Amazing to zap in close again or something, because that's just, it would take forever. Just take way too long. Spacebar is my new best friend. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you for the spacebar. I think that was Frostflight. I don't remember who said mentioned that, but it's pretty awesome. Thank you so much for that. Okay, and see, even to end these battles, it takes a long time. It just did for Reassembly to digest itself and figure out where we are. I'm really impressed that my computer has made it through all of this so far without exploding. That's really fantastic. I was thinking, when I stepped away for a second, I was thinking that maybe, and actually somebody had also mentioned this too in the channel and said, you know, why don't we do some, like, challenges where on top of the tournaments, we do like a one tournament challenge. So next, I'm going to do my announcement video on Friday. Yeah, I think we'll just call that. I'm going to do my announcement video on Friday, and we're definitely going to do a Faction 3 tournament, but we're just going to do it once a month. We're going to have one unique tournament once a month. So I think we'll do a Faction 3 tournament next month. And then maybe the month after that, we'll do like a build a ship up to 250,000 points. It can't have teleporters. We'll add a couple rules to it and just have a massive big ship brawl. That'd be really, really cool. As long as they're, because we don't want the tournament to go on too long kind of thing. So we wouldn't want teleporters or anything. Wow, Exciter, nice job. Wow, I'm really impressed with that ship. It has actually done quite well. Except you got nukes coming in, buddy. Oh no, Exciter, no, dodge, shoot, get away. Oh, he didn't know, he doesn't know how to deal with the Borg drones. The Borg drones actually have a superpower. Look at that. He's completely ignoring the Borg drones. That's not good for Exciter. He could actually, it doesn't look like any of his shields have gone down. So that's interesting. So the Borg drones, the difference, the Borg drones don't do as much damage. We do know that, but they are applying a little bit. Like, you can see Enigma's points going up, but not really all that much. We'll just speed it up just a bit here, just to expedite the whole thing. But you know, maybe, yeah, the Borg drones, they just don't do enough damage. I wonder, did anybody mod in this last tournament? I'm sorry, I should have. Checked more closely in the emails, because I know some of you did send me descriptions of stuff. But please, you know, let me know in the comments below if you modded your ship. I'm just curious. There is no reason why you can't. Not for the physics defenders. Go ahead, mod your ship. But I'm just wondering, you know, if anybody did, just let me know in the comments below, just so we can kind of keep track of who's doing what and how you did it. You know, I'd love, hey, if somebody has a tutorial on the sandbox mode, that'd be really cool. I'd really love to learn how to use the sandbox mode, and a tutorial would be fantastic. Oh yeah, okay, Exciter. Look at that. Looks like the nukes kinda maybe applied some, I don't think they can hurt your ship. I think the nukes can actually do a little bit of damage to each nuke themselves. Oh, that might actually hit, look at that. Oh, so close. Dude, that was so close. Enigma, that is a really cool ship, actually. It's done quite well. I think you won 3 battles in the Physics Benders. To win 3 battles in the Physics Benders is really remarkable if your ship is not, you know, a million points. very, very cool. I think that's pretty much it. Oh, look, we've got a little bit of slowdown here. Should we just call it for Exciter? I don't think we call it because, you know, actually, no, it's not Exciter. It's Enigma is actually winning this time. He's actually applying more damage than Exciter. Uh-oh, you might be in trouble, Exciter. This might be the end of Exai Sheet. Mark 5. Brilliant ship, by the way. Both of them are really good ships, but look, Enigma. Oh, Exciter got a hit in there. Oh, I missed it. Oh, yes. Oh, no. He got another hit in. Yeah, that's it. I think that's it for Enigma. Oh, man, it's too bad. You did really well. Did really well up to this point. Exciter's got something going here with this whole Faction 4 sniper thing, though. He's pretty good at building those ships. And we've got Exciter versus Decay Spider. Unfortunately, Decay Spider is going to teleport. No! Blast. Man. If you didn't have the teleporter out there, that would be really cool. There's no reason why you can't for the physics benders, but it would have been really cool to see what would have happened there just because I like to see damage. Can Exciter actually hit you from here? Will you teleport? That's a question. Oh, that would be... No, you teleported. Dang it! Dang, that would have been so cool! Oh, man! That's brilliant. I think we have to call it. I think it's going to be amazing that wins it. I guess. Nobody really wins this one, I guess. I don't know. Can't really say you won because, I don't know. I don't know. I guess you can, but there's no way. Eventually, I think those drones and stuff that you launched will amazing. I think they would eventually catch up to Exciter, maybe. Yeah, there's just no way. We'll just fast forward it through this one, and maybe Exciter will get that shot off right away on the next one. Because if he had actually applied some damage at the beginning, I'd say there was a chance that if you're just teleporting away, that he will actually win the battle by points. Will he actually beat you? No, I don't think so. I don't think he'd actually be able to destroy your ship or do enough damage even to get, you know, behind those shields. There's no way. But as far as actually doing enough points, having you teleport away and him winning by default, I think that's entirely possible. It's too bad this runs so slow, because it would be really cool to see the battle resolve itself. But, oh well. Yeah. Oh, man! Oh, that's too bad. That's too bad. Okay, I think unless... yeah, even at 32, so we're at 32 speed, and yeah, there's just no way. There is no way. Well, that was super fun. I called it. Yeah, there's no way. There's no way. I would like to... Hey, amazing, if you're watching, which I'm sure you are, could you take the teleporter out of that ship? I suppose I could. Nah, I'd rather you do it. Can you modify your ship so it doesn't have the teleporter? I know you're like, but that would mean it wouldn't win, but that's okay. That's besides the point. This isn't about winning. I'd just like to see some of these fights without that teleporter. I'd love to see Camo 5's ship against your ship without the teleporter. Anyway, that was super fun. I really, really enjoyed it. I'm a little concerned with the size of the ships, just because it really is slowing down the computer, and unfortunately, I think it's taking away from some of the physics benders, just because we can't actually see the resolution of the fight. Same with the teleporters. The teleporters on the really big ships, honestly, once you teleport away, it's all over. One way or another, it's all over. Like, I can't endure watching. But before we go, just because it would take so long to do this all over, I think what we'll do is we'll do the spinny ships, because I promised you guys I would do the spinny ships. So I think Hurricane is a spinny ship. I think Mind Spinner is spinny. Quadrillion, I think, is spinny. So we're just going to do spinnies. So we're going to take out all the big monstrous ships. 757, 832,000. No wonder these are slowing down the computer. That's crazy. Absolutely nuts. Okay, so we're going to take that one out. We're going to take that one out. Uber Max, we're going to take out. We're just going to do spinny ships. So J, Shaky Box, the beautiful Faction 3 ship. by the way. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful red sun. Very, very, very nice. Planet surprise was a big surprise. I would love to know how you put the plants on the ship and had them fully grown like that. That is really crazy. How did you do that? I'm sure it has something to do with the sandbox, but I don't know. Okay, so we'll take that one out, and we'll take Decay Spider, just because that's what we have to do. And Planet Mover, yes. And this one, and this one. Yes, so just spinning ships this time. I think that's just spinny ships. Oh, Frostflight, yes. I think that's it. I think the rest are all just spinny ships. So this should be fun. Yay, I'm really excited. Okay, let's do this before we go. Is there any really, really, really big spin? Yeah, okay, so a drone spinner is 100, 101,000. So keep that in mind. He will probably end up on top. If he doesn't end up on top, I will be super surprised and impressed with whoever beats him. So drone spinner is the one to beat. All right, here we go. Oh, this will be fun. Yay! I know we're doing bracket because we don't have time to do the other one. Oh, look at this. He is spinning. Cool. He's totally non-symmetrical. Oh, that looks so cool. Tron got run over by a truck. Tron got run over by a truck. That's what it looks like. Sorry, I said Tron. Who's Tron? Oh, maybe Annihilator is not a spinning chip. Okay, so whatever. Whatever, sorry, I screwed up. I thought he was a spinning chip. Annihilator, you are not a spinning chip. You just have a lot of missiles. I think we've seen that ship before. I don't know why I put it in physics spinners. Maybe he asked to put it in physics spinners. Anyway, so I love Quadrillion. He's a spinning ship, but he looks like Tron got run over by a truck. By a cement truck. Fantastic, super fun. And now we have Buzz Weapon versus Starstrike. Oh, that looks like fun. Starstrike is the laser, spinny laser ship. And I think Buzz, oh, look at that. Look at that. Oh my God, that's so cool. I think we saw this fight, didn't we? Oh my God, look at the damage. He actually did apply a lot of damage. Oh, not fast enough. Is that the best beam weapon you can have? I wonder if there's another better beam weapon. I don't know, because it's really cool. It's really cool. I'd like to see more. Of that type of design, just that, because it looks like it would just, you know, cut like a blade, like a rotary blade on a bandsaw or something. Like, it just looks so cool, like a buzz weapon. but it looks like buzz weapon's actually gonna beat you, just because you weren't able to do enough damage at the beginning, and it's just, I wonder if there's a better laser to use. I don't know, but very, very cool fight. Very cool fight. Oh, there it goes again. There's a laser. Oh, yes, cut. Come on, do it. You're actually getting through. Oh, so close. Oh, man, so close. All right, now we've got Lap Apps Now and Drone Spinner. Lap Apps Now and his little spinny ship versus the 101,000. Oh, Lap Apps Now, you are using a laser ship of some sort. Oh, unfortunately. Sorry, Lap Apps Now. I'm sorry. I would love to do the other type of tournament. Not the bracket one, the other one, the round robin, where everybody gets to fight everybody, but I just don't have time. Maybe we can do some kind of special or something during this week. If you guys request what ships you'd like to fight, maybe we can do something. Do something fun, but... yeah, oh, I don't know if that's... Oh, teleporting chloroplast. Man! There's no way. He can't actually... He is shooting something, but it doesn't look like he's actually hitting with anything. Yeah, he's not actually applying any damage whatsoever. He's just bouncing around. Talk about mess with people's head. I actually love the ship because it doesn't cause a computer to go... doesn't cause the computer to lag out, so it makes me happy. Oh, and you still win it. How are you winning it? You're not applying enough damage. Gah, how's that even possible? Crazy. Well done. Gurren Leg and Spiral. I don't know what kind of weapons. Oh, he does have some weapons on there, but obviously not enough to catch a teleporting ship like that. Anyway, very cool. Super fun. Angry Chiroplast, you're on to the next one. Wouldn't it be funny if Angry Chiroplast actually beat Drone Spinner, which is totally possible. Teleporter. Now, this is a different way to do a spinning ship. So most spinning ships do your ships at an angle. This, he did his engines are actually just opposite each other, just a little off. So it is a physics challenge, and he's using mines. Look at it, he's got the mines going. That's awesome. And Hurricane, this is Ethan's ship. Hurricane looks very, very cool. And it is actually spinning quite fast, and it looks like, what is he using? Is that antimatters? I don't know. He has actually applied some damage. He's not quite applying as much damage as Mind Spinner. Of course, Mind Spinner is using mines. I love the mines. I think that's so cool. And mines do a fair amount of damage. You just have to project them out like that. And the only way to do that is with the spinny ship. And you're actually applying more damage to Hurricane than he is dealing to you. So well done, my friend. We're just going to speed that up. Very cool. I almost want to bring spinning ships back to the main tournaments just because I think they are a legitimate tactic. Maybe not as fun to watch. And I think that is the reason why we initially took them out of the competition, because people didn't enjoy watching them. But they are totally legitimate. It is actually a legitimate design, but I don't know. I do enjoy watching the spinning ships. I think they make for some fun fights, although it is totally random who wins a lot of times with spinning ships that are the same size using non-TD parts. It becomes kind of this whoever fires first kind of deal, and I think that most competitions, most of the tournaments, if we allowed them back into the regular terms, look, I talked myself out of it. Anyway, bye Dylan on the chat. Bye. See you later, dude. I hope you enjoyed it. they can't actually hear me, by the way. I turn off the audio. Oh, there we go. Drone Spinner wins it. Excellent. So now we have For the Lulz versus It's Not a Swastika. Perfect. It's Not a Swastika. It's a really funny design. It's really cool. Was that a nuke? Oh, that's a Faction 4. Faction 4 modular gun, but it's not actually spinning. It's not actually... Well, it did... Oh, it's using the modular gun to spin the ship, although it looks like the engines would do it, except he's not firing the engines. I don't know why. The AI does funny things. Oh, nice shot. Nice shot. One more. There we go. Oh, yeah. It took him out. Just like that. Not quite. Keep firing. Somebody's going to win it. Well, he can't actually get through those shields. It looks like It's Not a Swastika is just kind of sitting there. He waited to rebuild. That is a really brilliant move. From an AI point of view, that is a absolutely brilliant move. But he just can't take the shots from the modular guns, which are uncannily accurate. Don't you find it a little strange that they're that accurate? It's really weird. And now he's just sitting there. Oh, we actually made it through the... And everybody dies. super awesome. Okay, so we've got Green Star versus a Null ship. So this is a multi-faction spinner. And he's using lasers. Look at that. Look at that. That's beautiful. It is gorgeous. Honestly, some of the multi-faction ships, just because you can have so many colors on the ship, it looks amazing. Look at that. Green Star is a beautiful ship too, but wow. The lasers, I'm sorry, that's crazy. Null, that is an amazing looking spinning ship. I wonder how well you're going to do against Drone Spinner. I don't know. Shoveler's Missile Spinner has done quite well, actually. I mean, it's dodging well and all that kind of good stuff. And this is Purple Electric Tiger back again to either punish or be punished. One of the two. Actually, good matchup. Oh, Windy Hills won it. Wow, well done. Okay, so let's try that again. Let's see what happens. It must be those laser drones are getting in there and digging in somehow. Look at all those, Shoveler and those antimatters, which, again, are uncannily accurate. Well, it's not as accurate as he was before, but the drones got him. Yeah, well done. Well done, Purple Electric Tiger. Awesome. Good to see you come back. Shoveler, you had some wins. Purple Electric Tiger hasn't had many wins in this last tournament. So here we go. We've got Quadrillion again, the Runover Tron versus Buzz, who's done very, very well overall. I mean, I'd say for spinny ships, that Buzz, he's got something going on with that armor. That armor is actually really, really, really good. And, you know, he's got a nice allotment of weapons on there too, but he is taking a lot of damage. I don't know what faction that is. Faction 1? Drones? I don't know. They are applying a whole crap load of damage. If he just stays away from you and keeps doing that, you might be in trouble. But no, there it goes. You just lost a whole bunch of your Lego pieces. Oh, man. Okay. Gonna speed it up here because I think he could potentially still win. Quadrillion could still win this. He has to apply another over about 2,000 points, a little over 2,000 points to actually win it. But I don't know. Is he shooting mines too? Yeah, he is. He's shooting mines. There goes the lasers, chewing right into the center of Quadrillion and loses. Quadrillion loses just by losing his command center. That's too bad. That is too bad. Oh no. Here it goes. He's going to do the same thing. I love that design. I'm sorry. I think Quadrillion's... It's just, I love asymmetrical designs too. You gotta have courage to build an asymmetrical design. And it's tricky to make an asymmetrical design fly well too as well. But looks like he's just, Buzz Weapon is just shooting you. It's just like, okay, well, I'll just shoot you. Look at all those mines. Yeah, the mines, not a bad idea, but I don't know. There's not enough of anything on Quadrillion to maybe apply enough damage, but it's still fun. I really like the ship. Buzz Weapon is going to take this one, just applying way more damage. We want to make sure that we keep this moving because this is going to be a long video. I think our last Physics Benders was only like 20 minutes. This was like hours, hours and hours and hours. I'm probably going to have, oh my god, look at that. Angry Chloroplast has a dirty secret. Oh my god. This is the first time we've seen this from Angry Chloroplast. That is crazy. Oh my god. Up to now, all he's done is teleport, but look at this. Wow, that is incredible. What is that? That's nuts. Wow. But he still can't apply enough damage to take down the shields on a... Yeah, well, you gotta keep in mind, Drone Spinner is 102,000, and as he spins, he goes around, and the shields recharge on the other side, and... Wow, okay, so we're just gonna speed that right up. That is nuts! So, Angry Chloroplast, up to this point, all he's done is teleport and win battles, and now he's finally realized the only way he's gonna win this battle is by fighting, and that's exactly what he's doing. Angry Chloroplast is beating 101,000 P-Ship. That is nuts! Look at this. Oh, he actually took out some of the shields on the edge. I think. Maybe. A little bit. Yeah, he's actually applying a little bit of damage, like core damage in there. Not a lot, but enough to... And Drone Spinner wins it! How? How did he win it? I don't understand. He must have done something. He must have dug in there. Maybe they rammed each other and Drone Spinner actually just applied damage by ramming or something. Because it looks like Chloroplast is going to win it, but no, the drones get in there. Oh, that's trouble when the drones get in there. Look at how fast that goes. that is the most amazing ship I've seen throughout this whole competition. Who is the designer of Angry Chloroplast? I'm sorry. I'm sorry you lost, but I mean, Angry Chloroplast, that you have done. I'm just so impressed with that ship. That is nuts. Oh, he's got little, he had proton beams on there. That is cool. Very cool. And here we've got Iblob Mind Spinner. We're just going to speed this up a little bit because it's my bedtime. Oh, there we go. Iblob wins it. For the lulls. Looks like for the lulls. For the lulls is a modular gun. He's just got modular guns on there. Very cool. Very fun. I think that was Ethan123. Pretty sure. Very cool ship. And Mind Spinner has actually done very well. It's just using mines. Just tossing mines at the enemy. It's going to be really annoying. It's like, stop throwing your mines at me. They do a fair amount of damage when they hit, but yeah, it's a little tricky. Looks like he's almost hits and then... Oh, no! Oh, there we go. Lulz, oh, it's 1-1. Perfect. Oh, look there! Oh, he almost really went crazy with that modular gun. I wonder if he's got enough power to run that thing. I don't know. Super fun. And then he does this dodge thing, and he just kind of shoots some mines, and... Yeah, come on, get in there! Somebody do some damage! I have work in the morning. Oh, super awesome. Oh, Ford of Lulls wins it. Okay, so now we've got Null versus Windy Hills. I think Null's going to take this. He's a massive ship. And he's got nukes too. Oh yeah, look at that. That is beautiful. That is just a gorgeous ship. I wonder if Null... I forget how big it was. But he is a multi-faction. We know he's multi-faction. He has nukes and everything. I wonder if he can actually stand up against Drone Spinner? I wonder. I think Drone Spinner is going to win this one pretty quickly. Those drones are just going to rip them apart. Look at that. Oh, I thought maybe something different might happen there. I gotta say, number one, Reaven, you've done very, very well. I think I kept calling you Reaver. I'm sorry. I think it's Reaven. My bad. I apologize for that. Those drones, there's just too many. There's just too many. How do you deal with that many drones? It's just insane. That's nuts. There's no way. Drone Spinner, there's just too many. Okay, yes, you've proven your point. You are the man. Awesome. No, seriously, it's awesome. It's great. What is X9827? Is that how many drones you expect to be in the air? 9,827? Well done. Sorry, just speeding this one up. We know who's going to win it. We pretty much know who's going to win it. I would be, mind you, Buzz Reaven, look at, he's done actually the same amount of points, but yeah, there's no way. Okay, so here we got Four de Lulz versus Null. Sorry, Four de Lulz. I think this is where you leave us. And it has nothing to do with the fact that your ship isn't awesome. Your ship's pretty awesome, but Null just has a multi-faction large ship, so that's pretty much how it goes around here. Physics Bender's competition isn't about being fair. It's about being creative and fun. And here we go. This is the final one. And then after this, we're going to call it an episode because I'm going to lose my job because I stay up too late. Oh, wow. First time we've seen a chink in the armor for Null, I think. He's actually taking a beating from all those drones. Look at that. Oh, maybe not enough to actually do enough damage. I don't know, because look at, Null has done 34,000, oh, wow, took out a chunk, nukes, he's lobbing nukes, uh-oh, could this be the end of Drone Spinner? Drone Spinner has almost had a close call earlier on, he's taken out another arm of Drone Spinner, look, the chinks, unbelievable, wow, that was amazing, well done. Here we go again. Let's see. The nukes come in and yeah, just to rip off the arms like they're butter. Like they're butter. Not margarine. Butter, my friends. And yeah, he needs those arms because the arms allow him to spin. And as long as he's spinning, he's got some relative safety. But oh, wow. Wow, did you see that? Just totally tore it right off. You didn't need that anyway, man. Wow! Null takes it. He steals it from you. Well done, Null. That's awesome. Kind of the underdog takes it. I am totally impressed. That was a lot of fun. I would love to spend more time just mixing and matching ships. But I don't have time. So I want you to keep in mind, I think what we're going to do is we're going to do monthly challenges. So as time goes on, like for next month, we're going to announce that on Friday. But for next month, we're going to have the Faction 3 tournament, which I think is going to be 8,000p. Yeah, it's going to have to be 8,000p, I think. You know, maximum up to 8,000p. Of course, you can't have multi-faction. It has to be Faction 3. And sure, build a spinning ship. I don't care. As long as it's Faction 3, 8,000p. I'm going to officially announce that on Friday. So just something to think about. And then in the future, I think every month we'll do a different challenge. So the month after that, we won't do the Faction 3. We're going to do like build a ship that's 100,000p and we'll pit them against each other. They can't have teleporters or something. It'll be a lot of fun. Anyway, guys, I have had a blast. I'm sure this video is like 8 hours long. Well, it's probably not going to be that long. It's going to be probably an hour and a half. It's going to be super long compared to most of our videos. But anyway, guys, I've had a lot of fun. I hope you enjoyed it too as well. And we will see you next time. And keep in mind, the next tournaments are on January. I'm tired. You can tell I'm tired. I've worked all day and I'm up late. The next tournaments are on June 28th. But yeah, stay tuned for the announcement video on Friday. So anyway, guys, take care.